last session we have started with revision for second chapter, that is socialism in Europe and Russian Revolution. In our last session I have discussed with you all what is socialism. Okay, I have told you that socialism is a social change which needs to be bring about by putting an effort. When someone put an effort or when a group of people put an effort to bring that social change. Now when we talk about Europe, in Europe social change or socialism means there is a change in political, economic and society. Okay, and especially socialism in Europe means economic change. Economic change means before capitalism was there. Capitalism means private properties are there, businessmen are there, traders are there who are having economic power, and laborers and poor peasants and landless laborers are suffering, they are getting exploited. Okay, so to maintain the balance in European nations, they accepted socialism and they want communalism on that time. That means no existence of any private property and all the economic power is concentrated in the hands of the government. Understand? So, and I have also given you that when we talk about the socialism, in this sphere of socialism, there are three different groups who thought different about socialism in Europe. One is radicals, second one is liberals, and third one is conservatives. Understand? And we have discussed that radicals are those people who want independent judiciary, who want elected parliamentary form of government, but they are not the follower of communalism, you can say that. Okay, they want that there should be a voting right, but voting right should be given only to the property owners, and women does not have a right to vote. Okay, on contrast to that, jo liberals say they believe that there should be a parliament, there should be an elected government, but all the people are equal. There is non-existence of private property rights. Okay. And they believe or they demand and they want that change which brings that everyone will have an equal voting right irrespective of what property they have and what is their gender. And conservatives are those people who does not believe in a fast change. They accept change but not so easily. They are the orthodox people who are not accepting the change very faster. But for them, change is a slow process. Understand? So like this, there are three group of people in European society on that time who believes or who thinks differently about socialism. On the basis of that, there are radicals, liberals and conservatives. Now when we talk about social change or socialism in Europe or in Western countries, okay, that period of time which brings a social change in society, which brings a social change in Europe, is called as the age of social change. Okay, the age of social change. Now when we talk about the age of social change, this age of social change in Europe can be divided into three. Okay, this the change which brings about in Europe can be divided into three, and that particular period of time where change has been taken place in Europe is called as the age of social change. So the very first thing is industries. Industrial change, you can say. Okay, secondly you can say spread of or the coming of socialism in Europe, or spread of socialism in Europe. And after that you can say that many countries and many people in Europe are there who supported socialism. So support for socialism, these are the three sphere on which you can divide the age of social change in Europe. Okay, now when we talk about the age of social change in Europe, it has been seen that industries are changing. Okay, because on that time, as I have told you last session, laborers are suffering. Okay, many in European nations, as it was a capitalism and people believe in private property rights, people believe that the person who has highest property, that particular person has highest economic power. Okay, and politically also that particular people are supported who have more property. Understand? Because the king on that time supported those allies who are having higher properties, who are having more properties, because king they get benefit from them. okay, king get benefit of tax from them, king that economic benefit from them. That is why instead of supporting labor or instead of supporting labor group, what kings are doing on that time, what government is doing, the rulers are doing, they are supporting the allied people, they are supporting the businessmen, traders who are having more property. Understand? So when we talk about the industrial society and social change, you can say that it was a time where economy has changed faster because of industrial revolution, as I have told you. Okay, because of industrial revolution, economic change was faster. Okay, and because of that particular thing, what happens, there was invention of machines, you can say. Invention of machines. New trading system was there. Okay, and as new trading system was there and there was an invention of machine, what happens? Production increases. And to maintain and to distribute that increasing level of production in different markets or in different countries, what happens? On that time only railways were invented. Railways were introduced in Europe. Okay, railways have introduced in Europe and it has expanded in Europe, you can say, so that there will be an easy trade, so that there will be an easy transport to distribute the production in different countries of the Europe or out of the Europe also. So over here you can say that industrial, now when this production was increased because of the industrial revolution, what happens? They require more labor. Understand? European industrialists or European industries required more labor. So what happens? Men, women and children brought to work in industries. Men, tell us if men are working in industries. Now women and children also brought to work in industries. Men, women, children were brought to work in industries. Now when we say that these people who are brought and these people are there who come out from the villages, the landless laborers are there, the landless peasants are there who don't have a land for farming. So what they have done, they migrated from the village area to urban areas, or they migrated from the village areas to industrial areas so that they will get a job. They got a job from the industrialists, but they are not providing them a better facility. They don't have a proper residence. They don't have a proper residence. Understand? Proper residency was not provided to them. The residency which they provide to those workers, those residences does not have a good or proper facility. Sanitation facility was not there. Pollution was there. And about when we talk about the food, okay, proper food was not available to those workers. So you can say that because of this industrialization or because of that industrial change, what happens? The poor laborers, men, women, children who are working, okay, they are suffering with the bad working conditions. Okay, bad working conditions. Or you can say long working hours. Working hours are long and low wages. But the wages which they received are low. There is a long working hours, but the wages they received is very much low. And since the towns were also growing, property rights, you can say that liberals and radicals themselves are the industrialists, themselves are the businessmen. There are some people who are liberals and radicals. That means they believe in change. And they are the industrialists. And when they wanted to bring about the change, they want other industrial people or other businessmen to give a right, to give a proper working condition to laborers. Understand? That is why liberals and radicals started with the movement with labor. Isliye liberals and radicals ne kya kiya? They have started with the movement with the laborers to bring about that change, to maintain a good condition of laborers on that time. Understand? So to improve the condition of labor on that time, you can say that the nationalists, the liberals and the radicals wanted revolution with against the government to establish, you can say, to end the king's rule in Europe. Understand? So in 1815, you can say, in 1815, with all these conditions, because of all these conditions, in 1815, revolution was started in Europe. was started in Europe to bring about a change, to bring about a socialism in Europe, to non-exist the property rights in Europe. Understand? To maintain that inequality in Europe, which is there. Okay, there was inequality in Europe, economic inequality. There are certain people who has all the privileges, all the economic rights. They are living a very higher life, higher lifestyle. Okay, like businessmen, traders, and all the economic power is concentrated in their hand. And on the other side, laborers are suffering. Okay, they don't have a proper place to live. They don't have a proper food to eat. They don't have a proper working condition. Understand? So because of all these things, in 1815, liberals and radicals with the labor started with the revolution in Europe so that the condition of the workers will change. Understand? This revolution was bring about in 1815 to change the condition of the laborers in Europe. Understand? So in 1815, Giuseppe Mazzini, an Indian nationalist, conspired with others to achieve this in Italy. First of all, the revolution was started in Italy. This in 1815, when revolution was started in Europe, it was started in Italy. Okay, and who was the leader on that time who started with that revolution? He was an Indian national, Italian nationalist. Understand? That leader was Italian nationalist whose name was Giuseppe Mazzini. His name was Giuseppe Mazzini. Understand? He was an Italian nationalist who started a revolution against this industrial system which they have in Europe, and they want to change that industrial system which they have in Europe on that time. Okay, because our laborers are exploiting on that time. Laborers are getting exploited by industrialists. Labor are getting exploited by businessmen. And government only supports the business class people because they have a property right. They have an economic power. They have money. Understand? So that was the that was all about the industrial change which brings about in Europe. This was a start, okay? This was a start where European people think to start the revolution. And the revolution first started in Italy. Understand? So that was a start of bringing a social change, or that was a start in bringing the change in industrial system. Understand? Next one, when we talk about, as if we have seen that industrial worker tries to change the condition of industries, or try to change the condition of industrial system in Europe. The second one is spread of socialism in Europe. As revolution started in Europe from Italy, okay, from Italy, as revolution started in Europe, what happens? That revolution is started in Italy, it spread in all over the Europe. All over the European countries try to support that revolution, understand? And each and every country on that time in Europe is thinking about that social change, that industrial change which they required. Because each and every country in Europe on that time is capitalist country because of the industrial revolution, and people, especially laborers, are getting exploited. Understand? As if we can say that is why we have a World Labor Act, to World Labor Day. Okay, we celebrate World Labor Day or Women's Day because of this particular revolution, because of the socialism in Europe. Okay, because one revolution was there in Europe which is highly supported by women's also. And that particular day is celebrated as International Women's Day. Understand? And Labor Day, International Labor Day, is also celebrated because of that particular revolution which started in Europe to bring about change, to bring about socialism in Europe. Understand? So now we will see that the coming of socialism to Europe, or the spread of socialism in Europe. How socialism spread in Europe, now we will see that. So now when we talk about the socialism in mid-19th century, okay, spread of socialism in Europe was in mid-19th century. Mid-19th century. It started in 18th century. Socialism in Europe, socialism started in 18th century, but it spread in Europe in mid-19th century. Understand? In mid-19th century, socialism was started in Europe, and when it was started in Europe, what the people believe, people were against property rights, against private property, because private property gives economic power in the you can say that private properties concentrate economic power in the hands of few, and other people are suffering because of that. Understand? Like in India also, you can see that we are you can see many places where, especially in America, where America is a capitalist country, when we say that. So over there, economic power is concentrated only in the hands of few. okay, and other people, like 80% of people in America is having a good condition, but 20% of people who are small laborers, who are small peasants, nowadays also they are suffering. Okay, they are suffering because they don't have economic power, they don't have enough money to live. Understand? So 20% they also suffered with that particular thing which on that time Europe is suffering. Now in India also you can say economic power is concentrated in the hands of few, yes or no? There are a certain industrialists, there are certain businessmen who has more economic power than other people. And other people, there are some people who don't have enough money to have a 2 times meal. Understand that economic inequality was there in each and every place in the world. And when we talk about Russia, Russia is also having the same thing, but in Russia what happens, the economic power is concentrated in the hands of the government. So now whatever property Russia had, it was the property of the government. There is no private property kind of thing in Russia, understand? There is no private business kind of thing in Russia. Because of which what happens, there was no exploitation with laborers. Laborers have equal rights, okay? Laborers have better conditions in Russia. Because nowadays also, we can say that Russia is a communist country. Russia is a socialist country. Last session also I have told you. Okay, now we will see that in Russian Revolution afterwards. Now when we talk about the spread of socialism in Europe, mid-19th century, it started in Europe, or started spreading in Europe, and it was against private property rights and okay, now when we talk about spread of socialism in Europe, there were different people who started a revolution or started an agitation, you can say, different period of time to spread the socialism in Europe, to bring about the social change in Europe. Now we will see what are those, who are those people and what period of time they have started with the revolution. Like you can say over here, Robert Owen. Okay, Robert Owen in 1771 to 1858. Okay, Robert Owen. He was the English manufacturer sought to build a cooperative community called New Harmony in Indiana. Okay, what he has done, he started that movement in England. Okay, he started with one cooperative movement. Okay, the name of the movement is New Harmony in Indiana. Okay, started that movement in USA. In USA, Robert Owen started one movement which is called as New Harmony in Indiana. Because as I have told you, USA, or you can say Indiana, USA and England is on the time capitalist country, okay? So that is why the movement started in those places who follow capitalism, and they are in the favor of the industrialists and they are in the favor of the businessmen, not supporting the laborers. So first of all, Robert Owen, 1771 to 1858, the birthday, he was started a movement in USA which is called as New Harmony in Indiana. That was a cooperative movement, understand, which started against the industrialists, which started against the capitalism. Okay, that movement was started against the capitalism. Now, after that, in France also, there was one movement, labor movement. All these are the labor movement, understand? To improve the condition of labor. All these movements which we are learning is a movement which started to give support to laborers. That movement was started in the support of labor. So, all these movements are the labor movement. First in Italy, we have seen Italy was started in 1815, then after that it was started in USA by Robert Owen, and after this in France also the movement started by Louis Blanc. Okay, Louis Blanc started a movement 1830 to 1882. Okay, he was started with the movement in France on that time. And he encouraged the government to replace capitalism in socialism. Understand? The movement was started in France to replace the capitalism or to replace the government. They wanted to replace, the government has been replaced. Yes or no? There was a democracy. After French Revolution, there was a democracy. But on that time, democracy was there, but capitalism was also there. So that is why this movement was started by Louis Blanc, so that there will be a socialism in France and capitalism will be removed. Understand? The next next one you can say that on the time as if I have told you this idea of socialism and this idea of communalism has given by Karl Marx, a German philosopher. Understand? Karl Marx is a German philosopher who gave the idea of socialism to European nations. And there are many followers of Karl Marx. You can see Karl Marx has written one book also on communalism, or on in the favor of communalism or in the against capitalism. Capitalism ke against mein Karl Marx has written one book, and in that book he has given an idea of communalism. He supported the communalism. Now what is communalism according to Karl Marx? According to Karl Marx, Karl Marx believes that there are two groups in society. Okay, haves and have-nots. Haves means the people who has everything, they have all the economic power concentrated in their hands. And have-nots means poor people, peasants, laborers who don't have any economic power, and they are suffering because of it. Karl Marx believed that the industries which are there, who are growing day by day, who are getting profit, it is because of the laborers. Because laborers are working for industries. If laborers are not there, if they are not working for industries, then industries will not grow. Then industries will not have a success. That is why Karl Marx demands communalism, that industrial rights or property rights should be given equally to all. Understand? That means he believes that when industries are there, the industries will not in the ownership of the businessman, or the industries are not in the ownership of the investors, but the ownership will be equally divided between laborers and owners. Understand? He believes in that. He believes in equal property rights. He believes in equal economic power. Understand, divided between both industrialists and the laborers. So when we talk about Karl Marx, many people in Europe inspired by idea given by Karl Marx. Okay, and Karl Marx was a German philosopher. And he has given an idea of communalism. Communalism and socialism, this idea was given by Karl Marx. Understand? This idea was given by Karl Marx. Now when we talk about the Karl Marx, after Karl Marx, you can say there are many other writers also who supported socialism in Europe through their writings. They inspired people through their writings. Like we have Friedrich Engels. Okay, and Marx also argued, one more writer was there, that is Friedrich Riegel. Okay, he also given certain writings about the socialism. Now these two writers are there, Karl Marx and Friedrich Riegel, who inspired socialism in Europe, who inspired people of Europe on that time to bring about social change. See what happens, many times you can see that many writings are there, with those writings we got inspired. We got inspiration from those writings. In a similar way, over here also you can say that Karl Marx was a writer, or Karl Marx was the main writer who inspired the Europe to bring about a social change, to bring about a socialism in Europe. And as I have told you, he believed in the equal property rights. He believed in the idea of, exploiting capitalism. Okay, he believed that capitalism should be stopped and there should be socialism. There should be equal property rights given to all. Understand? So this was all about the spread of socialism in Europe because of the Karl Marx, and there are different movements.